Get all the invitations out to the campaigns, but tonight my guest is a former member of the House of Delegates representing parts of Prince William and Stafford counties, a criminal defense attorney, and one of the first African-American women to graduate from VMI. That's Jennifer Carroll Foy, up late with me on the Final Five. Thank you so much for joining me tonight.
Absolutely. Thank you for having me, Jim. Okay. It's a pleasure to be here.
And here's the thing. It's a lengthy list. You know that right now. Everybody wants to be the governor of Virginia every 4 years. So why does Jennifer Carroll Foy want to be the next governor?
So I want to be the next governor because this broken status quo has not been working for so many Virginians. People are still working 40 hours a week and bringing home $14,000 a year. There are families who are cutting up prescription pills and rationing insulin. So while some people have been doing well, when I travel the Commonwealth to have community conversations, there are so many people who are not. So Virginians want a governor who will stand with them, who understands the challenges that they face, stand shoulder to shoulder with them and not special interests. And I intimately understand these challenges as a public defender and foster mom who stood up fighting for people who can't fight for themselves, as a legislator expanding Medicaid to over 500,000 Virginians, ratifying the Equal Rights Amendment for women's equality and helping veterans open small businesses. And I'll do more as the next governor.
We know that Virginia is an interesting state. The demographics, the politics of Virginia have changed over the last several years. Democrats have had the state house. Of course, Governor Northam can do one term and then he's over and done with. But when you look at the state of Virginia, which, you know, we look at the issues affecting people here in Northern Virginia, the people who are watching this tonight. But we know that Virginia is a large commonwealth where you have people, you have parts of the state that are red, that are reliably red, that have what they believe to be different values, different issues, different areas of concern than maybe people in Northern Virginia. So how do you run as a governor? And this sounds like a cliche term, but how do you run for governor of all of Virginia when people will say, well, she's just from Northern Virginia?
Absolutely. So I go back to my roots and I say I was born and bred in Petersburg. Petersburg is Southside Virginia, and it is one of the poorest communities in all of the Commonwealth, with one of the highest child poverty rates and rates of unaccredited schools. So I understand and identify the struggles that so many families face across this Commonwealth. And I show up and I listen to the people and I will pass the bills and budgets that's going to address the hurt and harm that so many communities and families face on a daily basis. And that doesn't matter if you have a D, I, or R beside your name. I am here to be everyone's governor because I know that what unites us is greater than what divides us.
There's a new poll out that as you look at the Democratic field, which right now I believe we have 5 candidates, former Governor Terry McAuliffe at 26%, Justin Fairfax at 12%, and then you and Jennifer McClellan at both at 4%. Either way, it would be a history-making choice because there has not been a woman to serve as governor of Virginia. But when we talk about the field right now, you look at Governor McAuliffe, who has served. He served 4 years. When you look at him, do you consider that? Do you think his time is done as governor? Do you think that he did his 4 years? I mean, clearly, he's asking the voters to give him another 4 years, which in Virginia, it's unique from other states because you don't get to serve back-to-back terms here. So when you look at the name recognition of a Terry McAuliffe, how do you stand out there?
Absolutely. So polls change every day. And I'm excited to continue to share my positive vision for Virginia because we are running a people-powered campaign. And what I'm hearing from my community conversations is that people are ready to move forward and not back. They want change because the broken status quo isn't working for so many families. And we don't get change by recycling the same old policies and politicians of the past. We get change by electing a new leader with a clear vision and bold ideas on exactly how to move Virginia forward and a record of getting the job done.
Before I let you go, you got a pretty big endorsement last week, Amalgamated Transit Union, which they've had a changing record of endorsements in 2016 for president. They endorsed Bernie Sanders. They endorsed Joe Biden the last time around. That is a big deal to get that kind of union support. But when you look at the Democratic Party, do you consider yourself a Joe Biden Democrat, a Bernie Sanders Democrat? Where do you fall on the spectrum when it comes to a big tent party like the Democratic Party?
So at the end of the day, we've seen the racial wealth gap grow. We've seen prescription costs rising and childcare become unaffordable and inaccessible for so many people. People are sick and tired of corporate corruption and the status quo, making things worse. So I am a working mom of two three-year-olds. My husband and I pay a second mortgage every month called childcare. We're shadowed with student loan debt. So at the end of the day, people see themselves in me and they see themselves in this race. And I understand the values that need to be be put forth. So what this is really about is a leader who's right for this moment, someone who will bring people with her. And that is exactly why I'm running for governor.
June 8th is the primary. I'm telling you, Jennifer, after we went through the presidential election, everything that followed, I don't know if we're ready for another race, but here we go. Jennifer Carroll Foy joining me on the Final Five. Thank you so much tonight. I appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Final Five back after this.